So Nintendo, out of nowhere, announced the Switch 2.
Just kidding!
It's Xenoblade X on the Switch! Oh my, we're still getting Switch games!
Wait, what?
Yeah, so this just came out of nowhere. Around this time, people were getting antsy like, hurry up, man, we want the Switch too. The old girl is dying, she's on her last breath. Please give us a new console. And yeah, Nintendo heard all that, they were listening. And they go, ah, screw it, unleash the Xenoblade Remaster. Yes, so Xenoblade Chronicles X, I made an old video about it, but essentially, this was possibly the best Wii U exclusive game, and I really liked it. Think of it like a single player MMO. You make your character, as you are humans that escape Earth to then find shelter on this hostile planet, and have to set up and survive with a really cool story and lore, and mechs, a whole lot of mechs. It being set in the future was also so cool because it allowed for more of these interesting designs on the worlds and characters, where everything has this avatar, the blue one kind of vibe to it, you know, exoskeletons, military, but the weapons and moves also feel very sci-fi. I mean, just look at this game. I love sci-fi JRPGs so much. This is such a rare thing. We have to praise it so much to give us more. And the combat had you trying to expand your base over the story, then coming into contact with the inhabitants, but also these crazy monster designs. And you have all this gameplay. It just felt so fun to explore this world. And then you'd come back and upgrade your base and your weapons and skills, as you had so many different combat styles, and you could mix and match all the armor and weapons. A lot of people would say it's a very different take on the Xenoblade story, since it's more self-contained than the other ones. I mean, the voice cast is very American and not British, which should give you an indication. It just felt very different.
Follow Ball, that's the best name you could come up with for your super special thing.
And I love it so much. It's one of those few games that I legit knew nothing, absolutely nothing about, and then when I played it, I didn't want it to end. It is just that good. And then the Attack on Titan soundtrack. Oh my god, why are you naming the songs like this? They are so cool! So yeah, even on the Wii U, this thing was insane. How it just ran on this machine! This huge open world game, you having so much customization, but naturally, a lot of the characters look very crunchy. And now at the end of March 2025, we are getting a definitive edition on the Nintendo Switch. Yes, 2025 is getting new Switch games. And yes, it seems like Monolith are the ones making it. Bro, these guys are insane. They make so much of the Zelda games for Nintendo to run so well on the Switch. I swear, Nintendo was like, okay, you've done so much for us. So as a reward, we're gonna put your final game on the Switch, you know, because you just helped us with all our first party games. So now 10 years later, we're gonna get this game where they describe enhanced visuals, additional story elements, and more. So enhanced visuals, yes, even though the Switch is on fumes, just pull the plug already. The visuals actually look so good. Just look at Elmer here. It's insane, the visual upgrade. It's even funnier because Monolith actually made a 3D model of her recently. So then they're like, okay, you know what? Scrap all that work. Let's make her all over again. Is Monolith just addicted to non-stop working someone? Please check up on them. And yes, it is an MMO type of game because you can actually play online on the Wii U with multiplayer missions. So naturally, yes, they are bringing that back, and you can even recruit other players to be on your team in the story. It's a full thing. Oh, no, I gotta rebuy Nintendo Switch Online for this. And I say MMO because honestly, it really is like an MMO. You have a hotbar where you can pick all the skills that you want to put on there for quick access, and say something how you would see with, say, Final Fantasy 14, how they did the combat. How you can also zoom out far from the characters, you have these huge enemies and they have telegraphed attacks on the field. It felt very MMO-like on the Wii U, so now it's pretty cool that the Switch is gonna get something like this. And then the new story content. I won't spoil anything, but let's just say the ending of Xenoblade X felt like there was some insanely huge cut things from it, like they were setting it up for a sequel or something. And then the press release even teases and shows a hooded figure. Something about them will impact the story. Kingdom Hearts!
To the darkness.
I know! Also, knowing Monolith, maybe they're gonna make it linked to the other Xenoblade game so it all ties in nicely, which I don't know if I want because I kind of enjoyed how this game was its own self-contained story. But we won't know until the game actually comes out. And man, I actually hope this does really well because imagine if we could get some sequels, it could be like a side story thing to the main Xenoblade games because it really does feel like a different set of thing where it's not really focused on story, there's more emphasis on that gameplay and open world exploration. But I mean, it does still have some crazy sci-fi twist. Oh my, oh god, that's so crazy. So yes, if this new ending can actually fix up the original one, this could easily be one of my all-time favorite games. Also, they sang more things means maybe they're adding more content. Like I was thinking, what if they added some more mechs based on the other Xenoblade game? You know, not story canon related things, just a fun little thing like, oh, this mech is based on mechs from the other game's design. You know, you could have a mech based on Mithra's design. And maybe they could actually fix up the late game grinding, because if you've seen my video, man, that was a big issue trying to level up. So it's finally great that they can now actually fix all this up 10 years later, make it the best version of the game on a console where it can sell really, really well with this definitive edition. Since I know most people didn't even have a Wii U, no one played this game. I kind of think that's why my video on it did so well, because no one was buying a Wii U and I was the only one that like played it and made a long video on the whole story. I mean, even Tokyo Mirage Sessions got a re-release on the Switch. Everyone was dying for this game to get ported over. And what if they add things like more customization? Because that game has to be one of my favorite Ramonas I have ever made. Sorry, Code Vein is still the number one, but maybe now we can get more options for our characters, more things to put on, maybe even some like armor pieces from other Xenoblade games, make this a big celebration of the franchise. Also then, I have to ask, would you want a review on this game next year? As I'm sure it's gonna be the same thing most of the story till the ending, but I guess I can finally try the online since I really wanted to see how that worked and see how it runs. But I also am very worried on the loading times for this. But then again, they somehow managed to make this game 5 GB smaller than the Wii U version. Monolith, what are you cooking over there? What are you doing? Why are you so good at this? It also makes me wonder for the Switch 2's release, would this be a launch title? Like Breath of the Wild released on 2 consoles? But then again, why would you get the Switch 1's version? So does that mean that they're gonna release the Switch 2 later, mid next year? It's kind of crazy times for Nintendo though, where everyone else is fumbling so hard. It's so amusing to see Big Red just staying in their lane and doing this and still making waves. Look at that view count. So what do you think of this news? Will you be getting this game? What am I saying? I know you will. Okay, and scrap all the things I said. If one thing they add, one thing I want, let us cook the Nopon in even more ways. Please, he needs to suffer.
While I heat the oven, you spread the yogurt down your back too, okay?
Bruh. What the bloody hell is this dancing turnip doing here?
He's actually a potato.